Hello, my name is Léa Pali. I'm a PhD student at EsoLab and Bagap Lab at AgroCampus West and Angers University. First, I would like to thank the scientific and organizing committee for giving me the opportunity to speak at these meetings, even in virtual. My research focuses on the reconstitution of landscape trajectories of coastal wetlands using archives, historical maps, and spatial metrics. I'm going to set off the camera because it will hide some of the illustration. So after a brief introduction about French Atlantic littoral and research issue, methodological approaches will be described. Then first results on one of the studied site crosset marshes will be displayed. I want to apologize here. I intended to illustrate this analysis with two studied sites. However, only one on crosset marshes will be shown. This communication will conclude on a brief discussion and prospects. This research focuses on coastline areas and more specifically on coastal wetlands. Coastline can be defined as an interface area between continental space and maritime area. It is also a shifting area in the short term with tides and in the long term due to variation on, in sea levels. Coastline, those areas, especially coastal wetlands, are rich in shapes. From during the latest transgression during Holocene name Transgression Flandrienne. French Atlantic's coastal spaces have been the place also of major shifts in terms of land use and landscape. Littoral spaces used to be feared, considered as repulsive and therefore sparsely inhabited. Currently, it is the opposite. These spaces have shown the fastest demographic growth close to the shoreline. Littoral spaces is now characterized with numerous activities, as we can see on the figure one. This changes in use is well illustrated also on coastal wetlands. These spaces were once repulsive, feared for diseases, and have been drastically developed for productive purposes through large-scale remediation projects, as most of large Atlantic wetlands. Nowadays, these areas are internationally recognized with, for their ecosystem services with Ramsar Convention. Therefore, wetlands landscape construction have been punctuated by natural and social events. In this research, landscape definition is based on European Landscape Convention as an area as perceived by people whose character is the result of the action and interaction of natural and or human factors. Most of coastal wetlands on French Atlantic's coast are protected. Management of this natural area often encounters difficult application due to land use conflicts, but also to different heritage recognitions. In addition, climate change complicates management reflection and is considered as a real threat to coastal wetlands, which are characterized by low topography close to zero. Prospective approaches tend to be more developed. We can quote in France ADAPTO project of the Conservatoire du Littoral. In order to have a long-term vision of wetlands, evolution and planning, we need retrospective studies in order to predict how wetlands could react and evolve in the future with certain management practices. This communication focuses on the use of archives and historical maps to underline landscape trajectories. Geohistorical approach is discussed here. It is defined as an intellectual approach of events studied through different time with geographers' tools. This communication focuses on which trajectories can be identified through a geohistorical approach and more specifically by the use of ancient maps with geomatics tools. In my PhD work, three sites are analyzed upon eight formally identified as field site research. Here, we will discuss only on corset marshes here in Loire Atlantique. Corset marshes in Loire Atlantique region in France on south shore of Loire Estuary. Field site perimeter is present here based on geology layers and on protection zone perimeters. Archives and historical maps represent the baseline of this approach in order to have past land use land cover data which could be compared to recent data. The oldest map surveyed is Britannicus map, which has been built for military purposes in 1776. It is precise enough to be georeferenced and digitalized. Then a Napoleonic plan of 1820 here is used with a Coombe engineer map to have details of the shoreline. The Napoleonic plan edited to collect land taxes based on their quality is very accurate. Aerial photography of 1952 and existing public data of land use land cover I use to complete this inventory. Analysis of trajectory with 17th to 21st centuries land use land cover data aims to underline switching areas of natural spaces, and land planning can influence these switching areas as patrimonialization. Eight land use land cover class are digitalized: urban areas and associated spaces, culture, grassland, forest area, semi-open area, open area, wetlands area, and water surface. Numerous landscape metrics has been used in order to describe landscape changes. First, structure metrics link with topography as elevation, slope, but also distance from the sea or watercourse. Then, landscape metrics have been calculated on rasterized images of land use land cover of 1 meter resolution with Chloe plugin of QGIS. This plugin allows the analysis of surrounding landscape by expressing the value of a matrix to the center of a 100 meter grid with a moving windows of 1,000 meters. Connectivity metric as interference length between different land use land cover, form metric as pixel aggregation and composition metrics have been calculated. Structure metrics remain the same for each time. Landscape metrics have been calculated with the 6 data of land use land cover. It allows us to build a timetable. Each line corresponds to a grid, and this individual is repeated through the 6 times. All individuals of our grid are characterized by the same variables. Then, statistical analysis is based on a principal component analysis, PCA, and a hierarchical ascendant and classification, HTPC. For PCI analysis, some of the variables have been removed because they were too correlated with another, or because it was not enough correlated with dimensions. Also, individuals which remains in water through time and the percent of water have been removed because it was covering expression of other individuals and variables. HTPC is realized on the 6 data at 6 time and produce clusters of landscape. It enables the identification, as we can see on this illustration, of trajectory of each grid individual. That is, as an example, what is the sequence of clusters of the individual one, as it is shown here. The first results of HEPC identify 4 clusters. Cluster A which is an agrarian landscape with grassland and culture. Cluster B describes an open and wet shoreline landscape. Cluster C corresponds to an open and wetland landscape. And cluster D corresponds to a narrowed and urbanized landscape. Result of trajectory present 92 unique trajectories of each grid's individual. When we look at trajectory between two time, we can see that a number of trajectories increases and become more and more complex. Part of it is due to the apparition of the cluster D in 1952, corresponding to narrowed and urbanized landscape. The graphic here shows us different trends through time. First, agrarian and open wetland landscape gain. Then after 1952, a decrease of wetland landscape and an increase of narrowed and urban landscape. In order to map these changes, the illustration 7 show trajectories which occurred between two dates. We can see several changes. The oldest, which occurred mainly between 1776 and 1952, correspond to the transformation of open and wetland landscape into agrarian landscape, as we can see here. Between 1776 and 1952, hydrographic network and has changed and has become denser in order to drain the wet grasslands. Closed landscape and urban landscape emerges in 1952 and then are expanding until 2013. With this map, we can identify spaces with major shifts, as previous marshes here, named Saint-Brévin marshes. So we are gonna have a zoom on this area. This part of the site was originally a marsh. It was mainly covered by rush, as it was labeled on the map of 1776. This wetland has been drained with the densification of hydrographic network between 1776 and 1820, mainly. This landscape was composed of large wet grasslands used to harvest hay. Hence, in 1977, the landscape began to narrow due to semi-open vegetation and forest development and to urbanization growth. It is linked in 1977 to the construction of Saint-Nazaire Bridge, which linked Saint-Nazaire and Saint-Brévin-les-Pins. Then, this trend continued until 2013, where all this part of the site is associated with cluster D. Narrowed and urbanized landscape. So trajectory are reliant on qualities of all map. With the Brittany Coast map of 1776 and Napoleonic plan, no semi-open areas have been found. We can question the apparition of the cluster D after 1977. Is it the consequences of a process of urbanization and abandonment of wetlands, or is it an inaccuracy of the digitalization? This method is also reliant on the number of clusters selected. With 6 clusters, agrarian landscape can be specified with 1 cluster which corresponds to grassland-dominant landscape and another to culture-dominant landscape. Also, with 6 clusters, trajectories are more complex. We identified 136 unique trajectories. And when we compare trajectories between two time, as here, we can see that there is a new trend. Trajectories do not become more and more complex. Firstly, the number of trajectories decreases until 1952 and 1977, and then increases with a big jump between 2004 and 2013. Sequences analysis on this 136 unique trajectories will allow us a better understanding and representation of landscape evolution. Also, to complement this analysis, interviews with Corecep users will be undertaken in the next months and will provide a vision of landscape evolution within inhabitants. It will be compared with the reality of archives and historical maps. To conclude, trajectory analysis can be useful to identify precise location of a field which matches with an interested trajectory. Also, this analysis will be very useful for restoration projects in order to have a better comprehension of different states of spaces before and after a specific planning. This method is replicable in France from the 19th century to the 21st century. In fact, Napoleonic plan has been realized at a national scale. However, it is not the case of Brittany's coast map of 18th century, map from the 18th century, which can describe landscape as scattered and not always available. However, military archives is often a reliable source for this period of history. Thank you for your attention.